Geophysicist Stefan Burns here with more breaking news as it relates to this massive, unprecedented earthquake swarm that's occurring right now in the Aegean Sea, just off the coast of Santorini Island, Santorini Volcano. In fact, now they've measured uplift at Santorini Volcano since this swarm began on January 28th. There have been thousands of earthquakes that have occurred since then. This swarm is truly unprecedented if we examine our known historic record of tectonic activity in the Aegean Sea. We will talk about that. Now the conversation has shifted back a little bit towards whether this is perhaps a volcanic event that is unfolding at this moment in time, though there are also strong tectonic-only events that have occurred right in this area, specifically the strongest earthquake to have occurred in the Aegean Sea with modern seismic data collection was in 1956, right in this zone. So this area is an energy hotspot, and in this video we will examine both the past historic tectonic activity to put this swarm into current context, and also what this could be if it is a volcanic event, because we have Santorini Volcano here, we have Kolumbo submarine volcano here, and then this volcanic field stretches in general in this entire zone. So this could be a big push of magma coming up from depth, and the uplift that we're seeing at Santorini Volcano is just at the very edge of that deformation. We just don't know at this moment in time. Those sensors have been deployed across this area, so we will have more information soon. I will keep you up to date, so please subscribe to the channel if you'd like to stay in the know as to what is happening here. We see that this earthquake swarm really accelerated on February 1st, whereas back on the 28th, these earthquakes were lower magnitude. They weren't occurring that frequently, but that already was a sudden sea change. And then on the 1st of February, everything changed very quickly. We've had thousands of earthquakes since, and they've started to go higher in magnitude. So we've had magnitude 4s, also magnitude 5 earthquakes, and today we've had a magnitude 5.1 earthquake, one of the strongest of this entire sequence. Here we see the cumulative magnitude of all these earthquakes. And so it's now starting to get up to a magnitude 6 cumulatively. And so we know that there has been quite a bit of stress released off of those extensional faults that run through this volcanic field. The question is, will this swarm lead up to a higher magnitude earthquake? We do see that across the Aegean Sea historically, or will this swarm eventually just peter off and that'll be it? Or is this earthquake swarm related to the intrusion of magma coming up from a deeper magma chamber? And that is why we're seeing this flurry of earthquakes that has not stopped, that really is unprecedented in terms of the sheer number and the magnitude of earthquakes in such a short time span. It's only been about 11 days or so, and this already has eclipsed some very notable historic earthquake swarms that have occurred in this region, in this geologic context. So there's a whole bunch of possibilities. The one thing that we can know is that very few of these earthquake epicenters have been close to the surface. Most of these are occurring 5 kilometers down below to about 15 kilometers, that zone. And so if there is volcanic activity associated with this earthquake swarm, then nothing has gone close to the surface yet, which is a good sign. Recent observations have shown that Santorini Volcano has experienced some uplift since this earthquake swarm began on January 28th. Here we have that data. This is two different data sets. This is measured via satellite. You see this angle of observation there, and then you see a different angle of observation there. And so there are some slight differences in these values. You look at them kind of as a whole to get a sense of what type of uplift or subsidence has occurred. And this is of a very short time duration because it's only about 11 days as of the time I'm recording this. We see our caldera there for Santorini Volcano. It's not just an island. This was created by the Minoan eruption 1600 BCE approximately, which was a VEI 6 eruption, ejected 28 to 41 cubic kilometers of material, massive volcanic eruption. And it's not even the largest one that's occurred in this zone. We also have the eruption that occurred 520,000 years ago, the Archaeos eruption that ejected about 105 cubic kilometers or more of material. So we know this area is very explosive volcanically across geologic time. Now we're seeing uplift at Santorini Volcano, even though it is fairly distal to this earthquake swarm. So it makes me really wonder if there is like significantly more uplift and subsidence occurring at the actual epicenter of that earthquake swarm. We see though that the highest values are right here in the center of the caldera. So that's also not necessarily a good sign, because that is really kind of the central focus point for volcanic activity for Santorini Volcano. We see that also at the other angle as well. And we see some really high positive uplift right there, right along the coast for that measurement, and also fairly being replicated by this specific angle of observation there. So this is recent data has just come out for this general time frame of the earthquake swarm, and I'll keep you up to date as to whether there is changes in the ground deformation around this area, whether it's Santorini Volcano or Kolumbo Volcano or other parts of the volcanic field, because this earthquake swarm is not centered directly under Santorini Volcano or Kolumbo Volcano. It's really in a different part of the area. And so this is perhaps related to the creation of something new. I mean, at some point there was not a Santorini volcano. There wasn't a volcano here. And then it got created anew. So that is the process of geology. You have the creation of new things on this planet. We can't just look to old structures to understand what is happening at any given moment. Though this all could be tectonic, because we know there's significant tectonic events have occurred in this area. Let's check it out. Let's start with our latest earthquakes map as provided by the USGS. And this is for the past 30 days, earthquakes magnitude 2.5 or greater. And showing all the earthquakes in this map zone, you'll see that, well, there are some others kind of spread out. Almost all of them are right here in this cluster. This is that earthquake swarm. And in fact, this is not showing nearly all the events. This is only showing just the highest magnitude ones. You'll notice a 5.1 that ruptured today. So this is our most recent earthquake that has gone above magnitude 5. We've had a magnitude 5.3 and now three magnitude 5.1s and also a magnitude 5. I'm pretty sure that's the total cap for all the earthquakes magnitude 5 or greater, but showing that this swarm has not abated, and there's a magnitude 4.6 also as the most recent. So this is very, very active. There is Santorini Volcano. Kolumbo Volcano is right here, just a little bit to the northeast. So it's right in this zone. Kind of hard to see with this satellite graphic that the USGS provides, but we can switch over to Google Earth. So here's Google Earth. We have the Aegean Sea right there. This is our Aegean volcanic arc right there. This is a non-volcanic arc right there, all related to subduction of the African plate underneath the Aegean Sea plate. So there's been a whole bunch of volcanic and tectonic events that have occurred in this area historically and across longer time scales geologically. And we have the two that we're going to examine today in detail to provide greater context as to what is happening right now. So this is the location in general of this earthquake swarm that's occurring. And then we see just nearby this magnitude 7.8 earthquake that occurred on July 9th, 1956. And in fact, that is the strongest earthquake that's occurred in the entire Aegean Sea since the 1900s, which is pretty interesting. You'll see exactly why. We also see Santorini Volcano right there. And then we see Nisyros Volcano right there, the site of a notable earthquake swarm in 2021 through 2022. And that helps us to understand whether this swarm is normal or kind of unusual, unprecedented. So let's talk about it. There are a few places in the world that have these sort of earthquake swarms. We have Greece, we have Japan, there are a few other locations. And often what we see with these swarms is that a year or two afterwards, there is a higher magnitude earthquake that follows. But something that's important to keep in mind is the geologic setting. So we have the larger geologic setting. So there's a general level of similarity for this overall zone because of that subduction. But the Aegean Sea arc is a more micro-focused geologic setting. And so we can better understand this swarm by looking at other events that occurred in very similar circumstances. And that would be this earthquake swarm that occurred in 2021 through 2022, right next to this volcano there. So to the east of Santorini, but still in this volcanic arc. And this earthquake swarm has a very similar magnitude distribution as the current Santorini earthquake swarm. We see that this is magnitude 3. Most earthquakes have been just sub magnitude 3, but we see a bell curve centered right around magnitude 3. Well, this earthquake swarm that occurred a few years ago nearby in that similar geologic setting, it had its distribution centered around magnitude 2.7. Then we also see the cumulative number of events right here, and this went up to about 1,500 or so for this time frame, which is 450 days. And here we see our cumulative number of events right there, which is similar for this data presented, but instead it's only for 11 days. So that is what makes this difference. The magnitude distribution is similar as to what occurred a few years ago. The geologic setting is very similar. It's near a volcano. It's in this volcanic arc. It's in the Aegean Sea. It's not on the other side of the world. But this has occurred 40 to 45 times faster than this earthquake swarm right here. So this is unprecedented in scale. There have been other earthquake swarms that have occurred in Greece, but they haven't occurred exactly in this geologic setting. So they are useful to look at, but they are not a perfect match for what we are seeing here. This earthquake swarm that's occurring right now is its own unique event. And so while historic data can help us understand what's occurring, we also need to look at this with fresh, clear eyes. It is useful to look at historic data though, and I have that pulled up here with this USGS map. I drew a box around the Aegean Sea right there and said to show all earthquakes magnitude 6 or greater since the year 1900, January 1st, 1900. And so we see a whole bunch of earthquakes around this zone right there. Actually, not that many magnitude 6 or greater earthquakes in the center of the sea. And you'll notice our highest magnitude earthquake, USGS has it labeled as a magnitude 7.7. Research papers have it labeled as a magnitude 7.8. In fact, is right next to this volcanic swarm. And so this super high magnitude earthquake, the strongest of this entire data set right there, is right in this zone where there haven't actually been that many high magnitude earthquakes historically, not like the high frequency kind of distribution on the edges. We see two other earthquakes nearby as well. This is a magnitude 6.1 and a magnitude 6, but this magnitude 7.7 by far takes the cake and is right within this area that is swarming right now, slightly off from the swarm because the swarm's more so right here, but in the grand scheme, smack dab in that overall zone and in that volcanic field. So we know that there's a potential for very high magnitude earthquakes. In fact, this earthquake killed 53 people and it generated tsunami waves up to 10, 20, even 30 meters high in very small areas along some of these coastlines, but then it propagated out. So it was pretty destructive and that was more than 60 years ago. Now we're seeing this new earthquake swarm right in this zone, which is starting to reach a cumulative magnitude of about 6. And it is in general releasing a lot of stress upon those faults. But if it is generated by the intrusion of magma at depth, then this is related to a completely different phenomenon and is not akin to this magnitude 7.7, though we see that the potential for high magnitude earthquakes does occur there. And so if this is one of these volcanic swarms, which then will eventually subside in a year or two later, or maybe perhaps 3 or 4 years later, we get a high magnitude earthquake. This is a possibility, but it's not high on the possibility list. Now with this video, I'm really just wanting to present all the information for you and then you can make up your own mind as to what is happening. I think knowledge is power and I think being maximally informed is ideal. And so I looked at the specific astronomical alignments for that earthquake that occurred on July 9th, 1956. What I found very interesting is the fact that it occurred right after a new moon. If you remember my last update video, I talked about how there is a greater overall stress on the Earth during the new moon and the full moon phase because of the aligned gravitational vectors of the sun and the moon. Those are when you have the most powerful tides. This is ocean tides, that is also Earth tides. And we know that shallow tectonic and volcanic settings have a very strong connection to those tidal rhythms. And we also know that the highest magnitude earthquakes almost always occur during periods of maximum displacement, which would be either at the trough or at the peak of some tidal variation. And with that 1956 earthquake, magnitude 7.8, it did in fact occur just coming off of that new moon. So here we have a chart for that. This is a Western Tropical Astrology chart, just so we can see some of the other interesting aspects that we have coming up in just a few days on the 12th of February that mirror what we saw with this high magnitude earthquake. So we have this, basically the moon right there, just having come off of a new moon. And we see that it is within 1 degree conjunct the planet Uranus, which is a planet of great disruption and change. We also notice that it is in the sign of Leo right at 0 degrees. And another aspect that we have is that Saturn is starting to apply to the North Node. It is only 11 degrees off of that application right there. Now, what is interesting is that in just a few days, February 12th, 2025, when we're going to have that maximum tidal displacement due to the full moon, we have this full moon in Leo. And that is typically seen as a climax moment, whereas a new moon is seen as a new beginning. We have a moon-sun square to Uranus. So another aspect to Uranus this time, also less than 1 degree, whereas this is a conjunction in 1956 with this earthquake. This time we have the sun and moon also squaring Uranus, less than 1 degree, Uranus being in Taurus, fixed Earth, which is very reminiscent of there being big changes to the Earth. And we also have Saturn applying to the lunar north node, but this time it's only 9 degrees off instead of 11. So a lot of interesting similarities between this full moon that we have on February 12th of this year and also that new moon earthquake event that occurred on July 9th, 1956 with that magnitude 7.8 earthquake. So is this seismic swarm right now tectonic or is it volcanic? That is the big question. It's one that really can't be answered. And I would say, just to exert some caution on anyone that's giving you a 100% definitive, this is what it is. That's very much a sign of hubris in my opinion. We know that there is a very strong tectonic component because look, it is thousands of earthquakes. And so there's clearly this tectonic event that is happening. The question is it related to an intrusion of magma at depth within this volcanic field? It's not happening at Santorini, though there is mild uplift that is being observed there. It's not happening directly at Kolumbo volcano. It's occurring just off of those two volcanoes, but still within that volcanic field. So it could be related to the creation of a new volcano, perhaps, or as we saw with that magnitude 7.8 earthquake back in 1956, this perhaps is a huge earthquake swarm that is opening up these faults that then perhaps could lead to a higher magnitude earthquake in the near future. And it also just could be an unprecedented earthquake swarm that eventually fizzles out, and that's all she wrote. We do see that the cumulative magnitude now is getting close to magnitude 6 and doesn't look like this is going to be ending anytime soon. Right now, we're right around that quarter moon phase. And so we have the weakest tides during the quarter moon. This is ocean tides, earth tides. They will be at their lowest point. They are strongest with the new moon and the full moon. And so it'll be really interesting to see now as we start to approach the full moon, how these earthquakes change as you have greater and greater displacement and uplift created by those aligned gravitational vectors. And in general, what we see is that when you have very powerful tidal forces, small fractures can become big fractures. And once you have big fractures, you can either have a more significant rupture along a fault, like a high magnitude earthquake, or if there is volcanic activity at play, it could allow for magma at depth to move much more rapidly towards the surface. We know that there are some very shallow, pretty large subsurface magma chambers at Kolumbo volcano that look very explosive based on some recent research. And we also know that historically Santorini is a huge volcano. The VEI-6 eruption back 1600 BCE approximately, the VEI-7 eruption about 520,000 years ago, the Archaeos eruption. And so we'll just have to wait and see what is occurring. But I've been your host, Stefan Burns, keeping you up to date every step of the way. So please subscribe if you'd like to stay in the know and smash that like button if you appreciate all the information that I presented in today's video, looking at all these different perspectives to try to get to what is actually happening here. I'll see you all very soon.